How's it going, everybody? Aloha from the Daniel K. Inouye International Airport, where the champ is home. Max Holloway is stepping foot on Hawaiian soil for the first time since capturing the BMF championship at UFC 300 in spectacular fashion. Knockout of Justin Gaethje in the fifth round as time expires. Man, you've had a couple of days now to process everything. How do you put into words what you experienced up there, the performance, the win, the moment you created?
Just blessed, man. You know, we had the opportunity. You know, shout out to Justin Gaethje, the highlight. Without him, none of this is possible. You know, he had a lot of lose, and he went out there like a true BMF, gave me the shot. Big UFC 300. To go out like that, man, was just amazing, man. It's all in the nickname, like I've been saying. I've been telling people, it's blessed. You know, people need to be reminded who blessed was, and I think we did that.
I know that this title means a lot to you. I know that the featherweight titles that you held meant a lot to you, but does the moment you created mean even more, being that titles would be held before and after you? That moment of making millions of people jump out of their seat around the world is timeless. Does that mean more than something you can hold and put around your waist?
For sure. You know, you want to be etched. You want to put your name in the legacies, in the histories, you know, and this is how you do it, you know. I want to top it, but I can't see it right now. You know, I can't look in the future, but I know that I'm still here. I'm still young. We got a lot more to do. I'm sure I'll top this moment, but right now it's going to be a hard one to beat.
Now, going back to Saturday, it started with Israel Kamakaviva'ole's Hawaiian Superman, transitioning to Moke Boy's Hawaiian kickboxer, Hawaiian flag draped over your back, the spirit in which you fought, the character in which you spoke. You truly brought all of Hawaii with you on that journey. How important is that to you, that the Hawaii people feel like that they're riding this with you?
Oh, it was, you know, from the island for the islands. I think you said it. I think you're the one that said it. So, you know, thank you for that. And, yeah, we just have to let the white people know, you know. Hawaiian Superman, crazy song. Hawaiian Kickboxer, I'm always walking out to that song no matter what. So I just wanted to show people, you know. And then I heard them trying to talk about maybe having a Hawaii show down here. And I know how it is, you know. I know what it is. I know how much money it would cost. And to be honest, I kind of came to acceptance that I might not be able to come here. So next best thing is the Ninth Island. You know, with the infrastructure, we don't have one big enough. That's just it, you know. And a lot of people, a lot of Hawaii people, we do this and that. I'm like, guys, if you guys want to spend money, like UFC 300 money to go watch me in a stand sheriff, be my guest. But I don't want to do that to my people, you know. If we come home, I want it to be big, be huge. So I was saying, we got a bunch of other UFC fighters on top of the roster. Brad, Dan. Maybe one of them can have a fight night here, headline it. And I can be here and just chilling and enjoy the show. But, it, you know, if worse comes to worse, they want to utilize the Hawaii guys. We gotta go back to Vegas, man. And I felt like you saw all the flags in there on this last one. It felt like a Hawaii fight. A lot of flags, a lot of people, a lot of Hawaiians in there. So it was amazing.
All right, man. As far as what's next, obviously, the options are endless. You're a contender for the 155 title. You're a contender for the 145. You're the BMF champ now and can defend it in a legacy fight against another Hall of Famer. If you truly had the power as to whatever happens next, what's the one fight you want more than any other fight?
I mean, it'd be hard to say if with him finally getting announced that he's actually fighting to be a Conor too, the running back. That's the hugest fight, I think. But legacy, ideal wide, trying to get back to an undisputed title, gotta go with Topuria. You know, he beat the man that I couldn't help but figure it out, you know. And but to see, you know, me and him had we're having a little Bible verse beef on top of Twitter right now. So, you know, life's good. It's looking like it's gonna be him next, but first things first, you know, Justin Gaethje kicked like a horse, man. Like a horse, you know, like, and I can feel it today. A couple of days later, I can still feel it. So we're going to recover. I got my beautiful wife with me here. We got our wedding anniversary tomorrow. So that's all I'm focused on right now. Seeing my son, too. I didn't see him for a couple of days now. It was hard talking to him on the phone after the fight. The guy was, like, celebrating more harder than me, I think. So at the end of the day, I got family to think of right now, and we'll go from there.
Well, we'll see what's next. Whatever it is, you know, all of Hawaii is going to be all aboard the Blessed Express for whatever that is. Happy early anniversary. Congratulations. Welcome home. For the BMF, blessed man forever, Max Holloway, Rob DeMello, back to you in the studio.